It's exciting to witness Konami's effort to reintroduce reimagined versions of their classic games for the modern generation. Contra has become synonymous with 80s action movie heroes, gun blazing and challenging run and gun gameplay that inspired a whole genre of games alongside the famous Konami code. Should this game have remained a relic of gaming history? Stay tuned to find out. I would like to express my gratitude to Key Mailer for once again providing me with a review copy, and to you for tuning in. And as always, if you like what you see, subscribe because it's free and help us get to 1,000 subscribers. When the Red Falcon terrorist group takes over the Galuga Islands off the coast of New Zealand, the elite Contra commandos Bill Reiser and Lance Bean spring into action, initiating an all-out war in which the fate of mankind hangs in the balance. As with many games of its ilk, the story serves as a driver of the gameplay progression. This is a reimagining of the original Contra that came out back in 1987, so a couple of years ago. Fans of the franchise would be happy to see some familiar faces and modernized renditions of boss fights. I, for one, was very happy to see the Protector characters because, fun fact, Contra in Europe featured two robots, not Bill and Lance. This game is designed for up to four players to play together via couch co-op. Players need to jump, shoot, and climb their way through the levels to reach the end level boss. By holding the ZR button, players can aim in any direction whilst remaining stationary for more precise shots. The game can be played with classic one-hit kills difficulty, or if you prefer, with a health gauge that depletes when you're hit. This update makes the game much fairer and accessible for all kinds of players, and I welcome it. Initially, the player can select either Bill or Lance, but as you progress through the game, more playable characters will be added to the roster, each with their own abilities. Bill and Lance, for example, can dash and double jump, whereas Stanley Ironside can hover in his power suit. This also affects the behavior of some weapon pickups that appear on the level. Speaking of weapons, these appear from flying weapon pods in a level, and two can be equipped at a time and swapped out. Collecting the same weapon again will boost its power and revert to its original level when taking damage. They can also be overloaded, which will destroy the weapon at the cost of a powerful yet brief attack or support power-up. These can turn the tide of battle by decimating the enemies, slowing down time, or giving the player a barrier. Bear in mind that some characters have unique overload abilities, so experimentation is advised. Another feature is the weapon pod that can be summoned when enough enemies have been defeated. There are a lot of new additions to the game that help make it more enjoyable and accessible. There's also a perk shop, which takes the points when you complete a level as currency, and these unlock many kinds of perks, which further customize your playstyle, and two can be equipped at the same time. Also, if you enter the Konami code during the title screen, a secret perk will be unlocked, although it's pretty pricey. The game is only 8 levels long and can be finished in a couple of hours, but there's an incentive to replay and unlock all the perks available, including the post-credit bonuses. Those up for a challenge can test their skills in the challenge mode, or just play in arcade mode and play without cutscenes and use all the other characters that they have unlocked. I value what Konami has done to bring this game to a new audience by adding new play modes and a perk shop which incentivizes replaying the game to unlock everything in it. My issue is the lack of innovation of the levels and their far too linear design. Obviously, this is my own opinion. The package here is a celebration of the Contra series as well as its European counterpart, Protector, but its weakest aspect is the linear levels. Purists will indeed appreciate what's on offer, and that's fine. But there was a chance to expand on the levels by possibly adding an alternative route or bosses just to keep it fresher. Amassing the amount of points needed to unlock certain stuff can be a bit of a chore, as it means replaying the same 8 levels. Although the game is truly at its best when playing with others. And unfortunately, I didn't get to experience that, as the game does not offer online multiplayer. But again, that's my opinion. Your mileage and your preference may vary. The game has some decent 2.5D visuals with vivid colors and elaborated backgrounds. There is a good use of parallax and dynamic camera angles to further bring the world to life and increase the dramatic effect. WayForward has once again done a great job at visually enhancing a classic IP with cool in-game movies and comic book segments. I did not encounter any major technical issues other than some effects not appearing as they should. Having received the review code sometime after release, I was able to play a different build of the game to that of release date, so I believe the game has had a couple of updates. The camera can zoom out a tad from time to time, especially during vehicle missions. The classic songs and sound effects are here, with a modern remix added to them. The voice acting does the job nicely, even if the script is antiquated. Contra Operation Galuga is available for £34.99 or your original equivalent and requires 6.84 GB to download. There are no physical versions out at the moment, but expect limited run games to announce something at some point. Diehard fans of the Contra series are in for a treat with this reimagining of the original release. There's a lot to unlock, and the 4-player couch co-op adds fun and longevity to the game. Again, although I would have personally liked a bit more variety concerning the stages and how they play, there's no denying that WayForward has done a great job at reviving a series that has had some lackluster releases in the past few years. Fans need no further encouragement, just grab it on the platform of your choice and enjoy it. Those sitting on the fence, try the demo on the eShop for yourselves. I am looking forward to the Alien Wars next. We give Contra Operation Galuga an epic 8 out of 10. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. Please let me know what you think down in the comment section, and let me know if you've played the original, if you think it was hard as nails, if you're thinking of picking this one up. Like I said, I managed to get a code way after its release date, so I believe the game has had a patch or two since, and I've had no issues playing the game other than the personal tidbits I've shared with you in the video. I've got a few other reviews, so if you wanna stick around, please subscribe, like, all that jazz. If you wanna grab any of the games mentioned here physically, or the upcoming Final Fantasy Pixel Remaster Collection, and simultaneously support the channel, please use our PlayAsia affiliate link down below. Free shipping on orders over $100. And if you're looking for the cool looking GameCube controller, the Nixie Wizard, please use our affiliate link for that in the description below. Use coupon code GRINNY for 10% off. Take care, everyone. Peace.